Time to play with some clay. All right, I got some monster clay warming up underneath the light over the clay, and because I'm going to be making fringe to go on the sleeves and that. But before I do that, I'm going to start working on the bottom part of her dress. I've got fringe to make on the bottom part of her dress. I've got this feature, this painted and beaded feature here to do as well. So I'm going to be doing that first. And then also, the sides of the dress are much wider than what it shows in the picture. And I want to show the wind or the blanket pushing the sides of the dress out a little bit because of the movement of the blanket against the dress, which will make it just a little bit wider down here. And so I'm going to start doing that now, and I'll be right back. All right, I had to open up the robe a little bit because I wanted to react to the legs of the woman and push in where the legs would be. And I didn't take that into account when I did it. As you can see, the armature's not all that strong. That's why I got the lower part finished first before I did the upper part because I had no strength there to hold up the weight of everything. I mean, I've got 10 pounds of clay in this thing right now. And actually, I've just started another block of clay, so I made this armature about 5 years ago. Well, no, a couple years ago. Not that long ago. Probably sometime soon after I moved in here. Alright, I've got some monster clay that I ran through my pasta machine. And I'm using it for the fringe on the bottom of her dress because it holds its shape better. I gotta get light down there. I'm down to one camera. My other camera ran out of battery power. That's all the time I'm going to have for today. I'll have to pick this up tomorrow.
Good night, everybody.
Give me a like and a subscribe and ring the little bell. Also, don't forget I have instructional videos available now online. The link below this video shows you a link to a review of all 9 videos. Later, everybody. Good night.